豪华新屋外观漂亮，内在质量不可忽视，怎么样才能看出房屋的质量好坏？吸尘器的种类繁多，到底如何选择才能找到适合自己的那一款？幸福有家为您一一道来。观众朋友们大家好，在上一期中我们介绍了吸尘器购买中的一些误区，不过大家可能都注意到吸尘器有着不同的款式，那么它们之间有什么区别呢？到底哪一款才适合自己家呢？咱们接着往下看。
吸尘器有贵的也有便宜的，但最适合自己的吸尘器不一定是最贵的。现在市场上经常见到的吸尘器款式有卧式、立式、干式和手提式的，什么样的家庭适合用什么样的吸尘器呢？
Generally find a canister style vacuum easier to use around the house than an upright style vacuum because it's easier to carry this up the stairs than it is to carry a big upright up a flight of stairs.Easier to do bare floors. Even though you have mostly carpet, there's probably some floor in your house still. And if you want to go from carpets and then clean floors, it's always easier with a canister vacuum than it is an upright vacuum.
卧室吸尘器有一条长长的软管，让它能够清扫到家具的底部。在有楼梯的家里，拿上拿下也比立式的吸尘器更加方便。它还有一个贴心的功能，就是让软管接上不同的小工具，清扫各个小细节。
Like this to get in the corners, really close to the wall, so you get all the dirt that's in the corner. You know, something like this, really good for dusting your TV or your keyboard, bookcases, and then something like this for doing upholstery. If you did a good thorough job, you would remove all the pet hair.
相反，如果家里铺满了地毯，家具简单又没有楼梯，就可以考虑立式的吸尘器了。虽然没有那么多功能，但清洁地毯是它的拿手本事。
So you can get a good upright to clean carpets for less money than a good canister vacuum cleaner, because there's just less parts to it.
显然，对于铺满地毯的公寓住家，立式吸尘器的性价比会更高，而且存放也不会像卧室吸尘器一样拖泥带水，占据很大空间。但它的缺点就是不方便清理家具的底部，而且噪音也比较大。
First thing you'll notice is that it's a lot louder. They're much noisier. And most uprights are a lot louder than the canisters. The problem with an upright is that if your bed is this high, there's no way to get this under your bed because this is as low as it goes. That's it. Now it does have a hose. So there's a hose usually with most uprights. So the hose comes out. But then,There's still no big cleaning, so there's no spinning brush. So you'll have suction, but you won't have a cleaning brush. So it's not very easy to get on the bed. But if you're cleaning a big empty space, the uprights are a good choice.
说完了大家伙，我们再来看看他们的小兄弟们。这种干式吸尘器看起来有点像立式，但它不仅轻便，还可以脱离电线的束缚。
Cordless vacuums are really great for quick pickups. So if you have a little mess in the kitchen or the kids drop something on the floor, rather than take the big vacuum cleaner out, you can just operate with something small like this. So they're very small, lightweight, easy to use. This will last, the battery will last for about 20 minutes. So you can zip around the house once instead of taking out the big vacuum cleaner.
小吸尘器虽然吸力不是最强，但轻巧好用，价钱也便宜多了。更小的吸尘器甚至还能够带出家门。
This would be good to clean maybe your car or do stairs or something like that. So nice and compact once again, you can take that out to your car if you don't have electrical next to your car.
选好了吸尘器就要开始使用了。许多人都知道吸尘器不能用在有水的地方。不仅如此，其实看不见的潮湿也会给吸尘器带来损害。
If your front doormat might be damp,You don't want to vacuum that when it's damp. You want to make sure it's really dry because it can clog up on the inside and create almost mud inside the vacuum and then it expands and then it'll plug.
还有什么东西是吸尘器害怕的呢?
You shouldn't vacuum your fireplace. If you have a wood fireplace, don't vacuum out the fireplace because the dust is really, really fine and it'll get into the motor.
有些家庭在地毯上喷洒带有香味的小苏打水，也会产生细小的微尘，危害吸尘器。然而，这种灰尘产生最多的时候，则是在装修当中。
So if you're doing renovations, you know, buy a cheap vacuum cleaner, not a good your good vacuum cleaner, because it'll do damage to the machine as well.
所以家里在装修之后，不适合用较好的吸尘器来进行大扫除，同时也要注意观察吸尘器的指示灯。
A lot of vacuum cleaners will have indicators if something gets stuck, say in the hose, and if something gets stuck in the hose, that will damage the motor as well.
这个指示灯可是很重要。如果不及时关机，可能会损坏了马达。在购买吸尘器时，还要注意保修时间和维修的地点。如果能够在当地保修，就会省去以后很多麻烦。小小的吸尘器确实有着很多的知识点。愿您能拥有一台称心如意的吸尘器。
市场上现在待售的独立屋林林总总，每个看上去都显得精致豪华。在付出昂贵的价格后，我们自然是希望买得称心如意。但是在购买新屋时，您可不要只看漂亮的外观与装潢，而忘了去探究屋子内在的建筑装潢质量。那么什么样的细节与用材决定着房子的质量呢？下面我们带您去听一听房屋建商 Mohsen 的一些建房心得。
Mohsen 是一位来自伊朗的建商，已经有十多年的建房经验了。刚刚完成的这栋 house 位于北温，讲起房子的建造质量与对细节的把握，Mohsen 显得很有心得。
I build houses around North Vancouver. Beginning, you have to do a land survey. You give this land surveying to the designer or architect, start designing. Send it to me.
虽然设计图纸已经完成，但 Mohsen 并不急着开始建房，他还要根据他的经验着手改变一些房子的设计，这似乎已经是他的一个习惯了。这栋 house 的最初设计中，Mohsen 对直线条的外观设计不够满意。
It was straight at the beginning, but I came up with the idea to make it curved. Because in nature, actually, you barely can see anything sharp.
进门后迎来了两个通道，一个通往家庭厅，一个通往客厅。Mohsen 说，这样的安排也是经验得来的。
In case your kids are watching TV, your guest is not going to be bothered.By the noise of the TV.
Mohsen 说，一开始窗户的设计都是平面，而现在看来窗户都是凹形的。Mohsen 为什么做这个改变呢？
The purpose was to prevent the noise to be echoed back.
原来 Mohsen 经常翻阅老的建筑书本，这一招是他从书中学来的。
1,000 years old houses, you see a lot of dent in the walls.
虽然 Mohsen 改变的都是一些小细节，不过就是这些小地方才会让住进来的屋主感觉贴心舒适。除了在建筑细节的面面俱到， Mohsen 认为要建一栋好房子，用料选材上也是马虎不得。首先他说，门的质量很重要。
I used the solid wood instead of the vinyl. The reason because it's strongerThe handle we use, actually the company I use for the window is all German, very good quality.
来到室外的阳台，大面积的透光玻璃让这里充满阳光。
I could use different, like a small skylight, much cheaper.
但为了更好的效果， Mohsen 还是选择了专门定制。现在要来说说家中最常使用的材料——地板了。
This hard floor is high quality. It has more meat.And more hardwood on top.
通常很多房子也都选择实木地板，但为了减少开销，地下室的地板材料会比主层的地板质量差一些，而 Mohsen 不愿意这样做。
So I use the same quality for the basement, the same as other places.
当然了，这些都是表面上能看到的，隐藏在墙里面的也有 Mohsen 的心思。
On the exterior wall, which is attached to the concrete wall. I used foam, injected foam, instead like fiberglass to prevent the moist getting in and heat goes out.
这样的设计屋主又看不到，为什么还要这么做呢？
I put it in because I believe major issue between people are trust.
牟森认为，当人们之间增添许多信任的时候，可以更好的合作。
The agent trusts me, and people trust him. And even they don't see the material inside, the people trust him. It's a matter of trust. If we trust each other, we can solve many problems. I believe and I hope people trust each other on these cases.
那么在这个时候，一个经验丰富的卖房经纪在看过房子后，就会了解这个建筑商付出的心血。
If you look at the finer details of the home compared to a lot of homes, that the builder is taking great care in all the finishing aspects of the home. There's no sloppiness. It feels like a custom home, even though it's built for sale.
质量的保证虽然看上去要投入多一些成本，但更多时候会得到回馈，也就是信任。而信任不仅可以减少人与人之间的矛盾，最后也会省去很多的成本。这个家也会因为房子的高质量而居住得更久。
房屋建造中牵扯到的质量问题其实不少，我们也只是讲出了其中的一点点，希望对观众朋友们有所启发。好了，这期的节目时间又到了。如果您对我们的节目有什么建议，别忘了给我们来信。美好生活，幸福有家。我们下期同一时间再见。